It is absolutely disgusting what is going on today. We really have a president that makes a statement, if they lewd, we shoot. And the sad part about it, the statement was made before 1967 when a police chief from the city of Miami said that in 1967. So that tells me that Donald Trump has a historian that works for him, a historian in finding racial quotes to energize his base. That's what the hell we have in the White House. A guy who consistently tries to energize his base by having an individual give him quotes, racial quotes from back in the day as code words to his base. That's what you have in a president. Now, what do you have in a people? People are now appalled. Oh, they're looting, they're tearing up their own community. They're burning up their own community. I remember that was said 40 years ago last week. 40 years ago, anniversary of Arthur McDuffie last week. Well, innocent black man got shot off a motorcycle by the police. 40 years ago, and it's still happening today. It's still happening today. It's a shame. It's still happening today. So, do things get resolved in a diplomatic way? No, unfortunately, no. Do I encourage people to go out and loot and riot and all that? No, I don't want that. We shouldn't want that as the American people. We are the strongest country, richest country in the world. But yet, we cannot get it right when it comes to race relationship between black people and white people. It ain't brown and blue and all those colors. No, it is black people and white people in this country. 2020, we're still fighting a race war. And unfortunately, we have gotten to the point using the diplomatic way of discussing the issues, we'll work it out in conversation. They'll go get some of the little black token guys, whether they're rappers or whatever they may be, and they'll parade them before the television network and say, yes, everything is all right, but in all actuality, ain't nothing got done. It ain't all right when you go get the rapper or the singer or some Uncle Tom football player and parade him up into this on the media using the media machine and says, oh, it's all right because we talk to these individuals. No, it's not all right because there are real people down on the street level on a daily basis. We know it ain't all right because you paraded that individual up across the TV on every network and said, it's okay. No, it's not okay. We still have these issues. When people go out and riot, let me explain to you. When people go out and riot, that's when they got to the point where they don't trust the system. They don't trust the government. They don't trust the local officials. They don't trust nobody that wears a suit that walks around and say, yeah, we got it. It's all right. It's going to be worked out. No, it's not all right. It ain't all right. In every city in America right now, it's just one police shooting, one white person shooting of an innocent black person death away from burning that place up. And then you have this idiot in the White House. They lewd, we shoot. Unbelievable. This day in age, in the United States of America, the strongest country in the world. That's where we at right now. And unfortunately, ain't nobody listens when you try and handle these things in a diplomatic way. Everybody listening right now. Everybody listening right now. The country has got everybody's ear. This went on since Trayvon Martin. It's a buildup from Trayvon Martin. It's a buildup from the innocent black man and his wife and the baby in the back seat, and they shoot him. It's a buildup of St. Louis. It's a buildup of the man walking out across the street and the police shoot him. It's a buildup of Colin Kaepernick. Black man get because he took a stance against racial oppression. Y'all went to the stadium. We all went to the stadium. We tuned in. We watched this man get blackballed. Did nothing. If you looked at a football game, and that includes myself, I feel sick to my stomach that I sat up there and watched a football game, knowing that these racist owners would put us in this predicament where we at right now today. Because everybody says, let's deal with it in a diplomatic way. Let's go have a conversation. Let's sit down. And then what they end up doing is they control the narrative because they control the media. And then they find some token black person and they parade them across the TV and they say, oh, yeah, it's okay. Take some real people in the room. Get some real demands made. Oh, y'all ain't gonna do that. So I don't ever get the phone call. Because I'm one of them other ones. They ain't call me. Because as soon as you walk, parade me up in the room, you ain't going to have me saying anything you want me to say because you're going to give me a dollar. Oh, no, no, no. And there are a whole bunch of people like myself out there that we don't go for the BS. But they know who to call. They know who to call. Watch the movie. Watch the movie. They know who to call. But the only thing that does is that's just put the icing. That don't even put the icing on the cake. That just put a little cover on it. Let's hide our racist tactics and continue doing what we're doing because we acknowledge that there is a problem, but not addressing the problem, not addressing the issue. So we acknowledge there is a problem, but do we do something about it? No. South Beach. Black people go over there. Innocent black people get killed, beat. Girls get beat like dogs on the street. It ain't just Minnesota. It's all over this country. This country is sick. This country has a real serious problem. It's got two issues. It's got corona and it's got racism. And everybody sits there and look at it. And until people start burning stuff up, then that's when people take notice. But nobody wants to prevent the burning up. Yeah. Kids that can't even get a job because of the color of their skin. As soon as they walk in to get an interview, they leave a university and they finish the top of their class and they can't even get a job because of the color of their skin. It's ridiculous. This country is sick. If you work in an office and there's no black people in there, you should feel like it's something wrong. If you work in an office and there ain't no white people in there, you should feel that it's something wrong. Right then, that's dealing with the issue. That's dealing with the issue. But we ain't gonna do that. The greatest country in the world. Greatest country in the world. We say that. We're not the greatest country in the world. We're the weakest country in the world.